Hi folks, my name is Mario Peach, and with the last video I showed you how to save TillWiki with the Beaker browser using the TillWiki pre-release. With this video I want to show you a new project which I'm working on, which is called the Beaker Adapter. So TillWiki has the possibility to include plugins, and one of these plugins can be a backend adapter using the Beaker API. Yeah? So I have created a new edition which is called Dat Archive, and I'm creating a new index.html at the moment which contains this plugin. Yeah? Needs a little bit of time. I just created a new site which is called Beaker Adapter. Here it is, there is the index.html file. And if I open it, you will immediately see that it creates a tiddlers directory. Yeah? And with this version, it's possible to create new content. Some text as single files. Yeah? So for example, now this one is called new content tid. Yeah, which is TillWiki's internal text format. If I open it, you can see it contains a created field, modified text, title, and so on. Yeah. So the file title can be different to the tiddler title, which is important. With TillWiki, there is a nice feature which is called tags. Yeah, so I give it a new text test here. And if I save it, Beaker API makes it possible to dynamically sync content which is created on the file level, which is very important for the users. So you have the possibility to copy content into the directory, and TillWiki will be able to see it. Yeah? So the whole plugin is alpha quality, so there will be some hiccups probably even in the video. Yeah? Okay, so I create a new file, new content, test, I don't know. TillWiki also has its own wikit syntax, and here I create the heading, some text, save it, okay. Yeah. So some of you may not be aware of the TillWiki syntax. So with the plugins it's also possible to handle Markdown. Yeah? This version is not compiled with the Markdown plugin, but it's easy to do so. Yeah? So I go to the editor, I include the Markdown plugin, which is called Markdown. Yeah? Save it. Create a new version, needs a little bit, okay, then reload the page, and now the Markdown plugin is activated, so I can create a new tiddler, Markdown, create the heading, text, save it, as you can see. And now we can see that TillWiki created two files. One is called Markdown MD, which contains the content, and the other one is called Markdown MD Meta. And so if you have the same file name with the meta extension, TillWiki automatically detects it and imports it as a tiddler. Yeah? So we have the created, the modified, and so on. Yeah? If I add a tag here, I don't know if it works, so maybe it doesn't. No, this is not implemented yet. Yeah? But I can reload the page. Then the tag is there, so the whole search mechanism, tagging mechanism, and so on works. Yeah. Other possibilities with TillyWiki, we have different file types which can be used at the moment. So PNG, I think, already works. Yeah. So very limited drawing capabilities with the mousepad. Yeah. So create a small fish. Mario's fish. Say save. Yeah, okay, so you can see, okay, there is a PNG, and again, there is the metadata. Yeah? So with TillyWiki, we have the possibility to create a lot of different file types. So we have here Markdown, then plain text, which is .txt extension, then TillyWiki 5 is .tiller format, TillyWiki Classic is old one, then we have GIF, icons, JPEG, PNG, and so on. Yeah. It's also possible to use vector graphics, but there is no editor included at the moment, and there is also no editor available at the moment. Yeah, but it would be possible to create different plugins like this. Yeah, so that's the project that I'm working on: automatic syncing of the file side or the file backend of the Beaker browser or the DAT archive, and as you can see, TillyWiki is really, really powerful here. Yeah? So that's why, in my case, we need the staging area. Yeah, that's it for the moment. Have fun and thank you.